Shit happens, and that's the way it goes. So now, may I have the original KY-102 air staff over here, please? Now, we're talking the guys. Oh, by the way, my name is Randy Rayleigh. Thank you all for coming out. I appreciate it very much. Okay, thank you. Love you. Love your show. The original guys from 1974 are going to join us on stage. So I'd like to have Max Floyd, Dick Wilson, Cliff Bream, and whoever else is supposed to be on there too. Oh, Casey Stengel, Catfish Chris Kelly. All of you guys, please come up here. That doesn't look like Catfish Chris Kelly, but okay. All right. So come on. This is... So if you'd like to get some pictures for your camera of what the original KY-102 air staff looked like, I'm going to get out of the way here, and I'd like for each one of them to introduce themselves and tell you the years that they were at KY. Okay, I'll start. My name is Randy Rayleigh. I was at KY from 1979 until 1985, and from 1989 until 1992. Okay? Now, this guy has never been seen in public since he left KY-102. This is Cliff Bream. Cliff?
Hey, everybody. July 1st, 1974? That's scary. Yeah, hey, it's, time flies when you're having fun. But I went by the Beamer and didn't know what else to do. I was the kid. These guys were old. I was 12 years old when I went on the air. And I was the midnight to six guy, started out, and then eventually seven to midnight. But I always looked at it as that it was a weird thing because midnight to six was like the counselor for everybody that called in. The phones rang off the hook, but... it was like, if you needed sexual advice, call the Beamer. It was pretty strange. And I think usually I told the girls, behave yourself. And not really. I think I probably said, go do it. But it was a great time. We loved all of you. It was a great experience. And I just loved Kansas City and just be glad to be a part of it. So thanks, everybody. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Catfish Chris Kelly.
Hey, hey, hey. Isn't this fun? What a gas. I had to move to Tucson, Arizona in 2004. In 1974, I did 7 to midnight when you were still in high school. We have transistor radios then? We did, didn't we? It's very hard to find words to describe what was going on in the building that day because we had been automated the day prior, and then we were playing stuff live. Max comes in every once in a while and goes, what are you doing? Are you still here? Yeah. But that day went by. It was blinding because I don't remember anything. The next years, 74 through I stayed until October of 75, and Larry Moffitt. Anybody remember Larry Moffitt? Larry up and hired me again in 1989, and I stayed through 1991, and so I've been to KY. Twice. Has anybody been? Yeah, there's been several others. We talked about that earlier today. So enjoy this night. It's been 44 years. Love Kansas City. This is hometown for me, and I know it's hometown for you, and I wish KY was still on the air.
Ladies and gentlemen, Casey Stengel.
The radio station, KY-102. Casey Stengel with you. Thanks for remembering me. Thanks for remembering the station. Got some Blue Oyster Cult and Rick Derringer coming up. And stay tuned because Max Floyd is going to have a major concert announcement this afternoon at 3. So stick around.
I'm so old back in the day, if we wanted to hear the Ozark Mountain Daredevils, we had to get out the vinyl. And I better get autographs. Little over a decade ago, I became involved with a guy by the name of Jesus Christ. Snot Rockets sang his theme song earlier. Thank you, Doug. Appreciate that. But before that statement makes you uncomfortable, I want you to know I still believe in sex, drugs, and rock and roll. The only difference is my sex is with one woman, a wife. My drug of choice is love. Thank you, Roxy Music. And I still love that old-time rock and roll. That kind of music soothes my soul. Thank you, Kansas City. Ladies and gentlemen, Spike Santee. Ladies and gentlemen.
Thanks for coming out, everybody. You know, in 1974, they did not think that FM radio was going to be commercially successful. And it would be surprising for them today to see this crowd for a radio station that has not been on the air for 21 years. It was really something special, and I don't think it'll ever be done again. Thanks a lot for coming out.
How about a nice round of applause for our original people, and thank you so much. Perfect timing. Wait a minute, he's going to do it again. I swear to God. Hang on. I hope he's in the right key. That's all. Thank you. There we go. Thank you so much. A KY listener, for sure. Now, if we hang on to Max and Dick, because we've got other people coming up. Ladies and gentlemen, how about Tana Guthrie and Larry Moffitt? How about that? Max, Tana, and Moffitt. You see, I'm the administrator of the KY102 page, and every time that you log on and you want to be a member, you have to ask you have to answer a question. And my question is, tell me something about KY102. 90% of the time is Max, Tana, and Moffitt. So Larry Moffitt, Tana Guthrie, I love you too, man. Ladies and gentlemen, Larry Moffitt, Tana Guthrie, Max Floyd. Oh my God, Max is shy, please.
Okay, when I first got to town, I was living in a van. Okay, it wasn't my van, but...
You stole it.
Yeah, I don't know how long I was on the air here, it doesn't matter.
And we used it for Porky Piggin.
I was stoned all the time I was on the air. Hope you know that. And that's I still am.
That's the biggest line of bullshit I've ever heard.
I still am. Hey, so is Randy Raley. Thank you guys very much for coming out.
Some bitch.
I never liked Tana and Moffitt, to be honest with you. But I had to work with them for a minute because
we tolerated each other.
You don't want to cut up your paycheck three ways. See, that's the whole point.
That's why we got fired. They got tired of paying all three of them.
I've been fired so many times, it's terrible.
They were like, ROI is not good.
But I want to thank you very much for coming out, and it was great to see all of you again. But Max,
can we say you both were lovers for like a brief span?
Right.
Right.
Well, yeah.
We're okay, right?
But
we
that's
can
before
say that.
It was. That was before it was acceptable.
That was my formative years.
Totally accepted. Yeah.
And Max actually was thought about doing the Caitlyn Jenner thing way before Bruce Jenner did.
I used to be a woman.
Oh my God.
Then he became a man and he fell in love with Moffitt and then it got messy.
This is why we got fired.
Yeah.
That's right. We blame it on that.
And all
you
those
guys
times,
are the reason we're not on the air.
Right. And all those times Herndon would come in and go, "Hi, what the hell are you guys talking about now?"
But thanks for coming. We appreciate it very much.
Seriously, we do. Thank you guys very much. We miss all of you.
Right.
Thank you for your story.
And I want to give a special shout out to some friends that are here from Clinton, Missouri. I live down in Tightwad now.
Oh, that suits you perfectly.
Do you guys all know where that is?
That suits you perfectly.
Tightwad, Missouri.
You never bought a beer the entire 35 years
but
we
I
were
have
together.
Just organized the Redneck Olympics. It's going to be held at the old Tightwad Bank the last weekend of October. So I want to invite all you guys to come down, practice throwing a toilet lid, because that's what we use for horseshoes. And, of course, you know, if you can spit your skull more than 10 foot, you're automatically in.
All right. Thank you. Cut his mic, ladies and gentlemen. No, I'm kidding. Ladies and gentlemen, Max Tannen Moffitt. Let's hear it for them. Thank you, folks. And now I'd like to introduce Mr. Dick Wilson. And before we go any further, let's take a nice big toast to the memory of Mr. Jay Cooper.
Woo!
How's about that?
All right.
Because without Dick and Jay, there was not KY. And so, ladies and gentlemen, half of Dick and Jay would be Dick.
Well, that's sometimes the best half, I guess. And then, yeah. Well, I remember the billboard that said, start your day with a Dick and a Jay. So that was a good way to get that going.
And you know what? When you didn't do the morning show with Jay, he was a Dickless Jay.
He was a lot of... I've lived a lot with this name. I sure have. Yes.
Sorry, brother.
Yeah. Talking about Jay for just a minute here, we had a good opportunity. Jay passed away in 2016, and a few months before that, we were inducted into the Kansas Music Hall of Fame as the first DJs to do that. We had a nice dinner, Jay and his wife, and my wife and I had a nice dinner down on the plaza. Jay picked up the tab.
No!
He died before it came in.
Ah.
That is handling business, I tell you. That's the way to do it right there. That is quite a deal. No, we so appreciate your memories and all the good times that we had and the times that you bring up that we forgot that we did, and those are good, too. I've told a few of you the secret about the Cadillac buried out at Worlds of Fun. I've asked you not to tell anybody else, so please keep your secrets on that. One other quick thing, the original five guys that you saw up here on stage, we had lunch today out at Jasper's and recorded a podcast, and later this weekend you've got about an hour of us making up lies about the first day of KY102. So I'll put a link on Randy's KY102 Facebook page and you can check that out. Thank you for the memories.
Ladies and gentlemen, Dick Wilson. Thank you, folks, very much. I appreciate it. You guys take care. All right, if we can get the rest of the KY jocks up here, we're going to get to the Daredevils here really soon, and they're going to kick your ass. Get the rest of the jocks up here. I do have a quick story to tell you about Soup Granda, though. Soup, when I was at KC95 in 1986, Soup Granda and the Daredevils played us in a softball game. Soup was batting, and somehow I caught a softball right under my nose, and it knocked out my four front teeth in public in front of 6,000 people. So here I am on the pitcher's mound spitting up teeth, and 6,000 people are going, ew. So for 6 months after that, any time that Soup Granda saw a picture of somebody with their teeth knocked out, he would send it to me with an autograph. Dear Randy, thinking of you, love you, Sue. Okay? So that's the deal. We're going to bring on the rest of the KY jocks for you here, ladies and gentlemen. We've got stuff up. Stan Andrews, ladies and gentlemen. Stan Andrews.
Go, sir. I'm going to make mine short and sweet because I was here, 4 years ago we did the first reunion. And I made a point then, and I'd like to make it again. And when you listen to KY102, you heard some great guys, but when we talked to you on the phone, you all touched our hearts because you were the guys that made KY102, and you were the guys that made us. God bless you all. Thanks for coming.
Ladies and gentlemen, a guy still on Kansas City Radio after 150 years, this is Steve Garrett.
Hey, everybody. This year actually celebrates my 40th year on Kansas City Radio.
Stop it.
Like a crazy fool idiot. Still doing Saturdays and Sundays at 101 The Fox, 10 to 3 in the afternoon. Thank you. Love you. Thanks for listening. If you never come to a hockey game in Kansas City, come to the Kansas City Mavericks. I'm the public address announcer. I've been the only voice of hockey in Kansas City since 1990.
And this message has been sponsored by Peterson Drugs.
That's
Peterson
right.
Drugs, go anywhere you would like to go. And Steve has now been sponsored.
As a matter of fact, our vice president of the Mavericks is here. And I got Randy tickets. He came into Kansas City from St. Louis. And he went to a game and he said, and I said, how'd you like the game? He said, it was great. He said, are you sponsored? And I said, what do you mean, am I sponsored? He said, everything you read has a sponsorship. Are you sponsored? So anyway.
There you go. Ladies and gentlemen, Steve Garrett.
Thank you, everybody.
Sponsored by our T-shirts over here, ladies and gentlemen, that you can pick up for $25. Now, before we go any further, this gal, and I have to get personal here, when I first got to Kansas City in September of 1979, I was on the air before this lovely lady. This is Lori Lyon, ladies and gentlemen. I don't remember if you remember Lori or not, but this is my mentor because she was the person who said, this is how you do this, this is how you do this, this is how you do this. And of course, being the guy that I am, never paid attention to any of that shit, okay? I'm kidding because she told me so much. Ladies and gentlemen, she worked from 10 p.m. to 2 a.m. Ladies and gentlemen, Lori Lyon.
Some of you might remember that I won my job in a contest in the fall of 1977. My first night on the air was my... Okay. Some of you may remember that I won my job in a contest in October 1977. Anybody in town could audition, and I was the one they picked, and they gave me a job. I started on Christmas Eve, 1977. I stayed with the station until the summer of 1980, and I loved every day of it. I loved working with Randy. I loved working with Katie, and I think I loved being the sacrificial news lamb of Dick and Jay in the mornings. They set me on fire. They doused me with squirt guns. They tortured me in all possible ways. I loved every day of it. I love you. Thank you for being here.
Lori Lyon, ladies and gentlemen. And now this is my sister, ladies and gentlemen, Katie McGuckin.
I'm just in shock you guys keep showing up. Thank you, thank you, thank you. We were just having a good time on the air, and we had a blast. And I want to thank Max Floyd and people like Skid Rody and Randy Rayleigh and all the guys, because I came in after Lori, and she said, watch out, you're going to be working with Dick and Jay. And yes, they set my news on fire. They were just so much fun to work with. And I've been on Facebook, and please, I'm Katie McGuckin Woolham on Facebook, and people have been sharing stories of having encounters with me, and a lot of them have made me cry. And you guys being here is very touching, so I'm not going to cry on stage, but I'll do it when I get home, okay? So thank you all so very much for being fans and showing us so much appreciation.
Katie McGuckin, ladies and gentlemen. And now, the guy that got you through the day, every day, the housewife's friend, ladies and gentlemen, Joe McCabe.
Hey, everybody. Thank you so much for coming out. I just want to thank you for a decade of my life that I will never forget and I will always cherish. And I would like to recognize two guys that aren't here tonight. One was my mentor, the late, great Dave Monday, who is no longer with us. But if you ever heard him or if you ever thought of him, give him a cheer right now. And the other guy I'd like to talk about is kind of our mystery man. You know, when you go on Facebook and you see Max, Tana, Moffitt, Randy, Skid, Frankie, Katie, everybody talks about them. One name that pops up all the time is Vaughn Mack.
Vaughn Mack.
And he did overnights, and it's just amazing. For many, many years, he's not here. We can't find him. Let's hear for Vaughn Mack.
Vaughn Mack, ladies and gentlemen.
And thank you, guys. Thank you.
And now my brother from another mother who I just had dinner with the other night, ladies and gentlemen, Jack Goes to the Movies. Would you please welcome Jack Posegar.
20 years of bad movies on Jack Goes to the Movies, and then another 10 years on 99.7 KY. Plus, of course, the old, well, do we mention it?
No.
The all-night blowouts.
The all-night drive-in blowouts, kids.
It's been a great gig for me. I enjoyed it a lot, and I appreciate your support.
All right. Hey, before we go any further, I would just like to mention a couple of people who are not with us. Ladies and gentlemen, let's drink a toast to Jay Cooper. Let us drink a toast to T.J. Price. T.J. Price was Timmy. He was the guy who was always upset about the dumb some bitches and all of that, and we miss him. And if we would have had the video tonight, you would have seen all of that stuff. So I apologize about that. So let us move on. This is a guy who did part-time for us, ladies and gentlemen, Rick Nash. Rick Nash, KY-102.
Hey, everybody. It's an honor to be here tonight. And on Saturday nights, we pulled like 25 shares when I was working on the radio station. It was pretty crazy. And to this day, people say, I know you, Rick Nash, from Saturday night, man. So it's an honor to be here. Thank you, Kansas City.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, a guy who I looked up and I said, hey, he's got to be included too. He was in the KY family, a part-timer that we had, but he sounded great. This is Wayne Eagle.
We were the guys that you got to listen to on holidays and weekends when these guys got a day off. Only rule was, don't talk, play music, shut up.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, I've said it many times that when the apocalypse happens, there will only be cockroaches and Skid Roadie that survives.
So true.
He will be on the radio the day after the nuclear holocaust happens because he's Skid Roadie.
That's right. I would like to take this time to announce my retirement from radio, but I haven't saved any money, so I can't. So I'll be around for a while. You'll hear me. You know, I've worked with all these guys. I don't know how many radio companies we've worked for over the years. We got bought and sold so many times. I don't know how many program directors we went through. I don't know how many, what else?
Music directors.
Music directors.
General managers.
How about the general managers or salespeople?
Yeah.
But I'm proud to be able to tell you in just three bumper stickers, 40 years of my life. The first is this. You will not recognize this. This is from Albuquerque, New Mexico, 94 Rock. I was there for almost 3 years. Matter of fact, a buddy of mine that worked at that station, Dan Mahoney, is in the audience here tonight. The second one would be this one. I think you're all familiar with that. That was 15 years of my life. And then this one is the last 20 years of my life and perhaps for the rest of my life. So a lot of disc jockeys work in a lot of places. In 40 years, I've only had 3 full-time jobs.
Unbelievable.
That's unbelievable. And so am I.
In 40 years, I think I had 30 radio jobs. I don't know. Before we go any further and bring on the Ozark Mountain Daredevils, I would like to take this opportunity to recognize these two people. This is Gay Boss and her daughter, Teresa. Her husband, her father, was the very first general manager in the history of KY-102. Let's put it together for Gay and Teresa. The very first, the guy who said, we're going to do this, was Ron Boss, and we thank you very much. Teresa, Gay, thank you, guys. Are we ready for some Daredevils? Are we ready? All right. Before we get into the Daredevils, and we're out of time here, but I do want to bring up one guy before we get out of here that has been my mentor and a guy who believed in me when I was in the turn-up truck. I got here from the Quad Cities, okay, in 1979, and this guy said, I think you've got some talent. We know that I all proven him wrong. But anyway, ladies and gentlemen, Bob Garrett. Would you please, Bob Garrett, Vice President, General Manager of KY-102. When the whole thing mattered, where is he? Come on, brother. I'd like to say hello to John Hart, too, wherever the hell John is. He's here somewhere. Bob Garrett, ladies and gentlemen.
This is amazing. What can I say? Herndon and Hasty should be up here as well, who did a hell of a job at KY-102. Yeah, let's get Herndon up and talk to him. We got to have Herndon up. Anyway, a lot of times people ask me about my experience at KY, and I try to get an honest answer. And because of all the people that have been on this stage, we had the highest rated FM rock and roll radio station in the history of Kansas City.
Herndon, where you at, buddy?
Herndon's a big part of this. Get up here, buddy.
Is he gone? Or is he just, he's not going to make it up on stage? All right.
Thanks, everybody. Thank you for coming out. What a great turnout. Thanks to Herndon Hasty for all his help. And thank you so much.
Ladies and gentlemen, Bob Beard. Let's hear from the Ozark Mountain Daredevils. What do you say? Let's bring the Daredevils on. And I got to say that when I thought about doing this again, I thought, who could I reach out to help me out in a time that I needed? And there were a couple of guys on my mind. One of them was Rusty Young from Poco. Okay, Rusty's a good guy. And if I couldn't get these guys, I was going to get Poco. But I was very surprised and pleased that my friend Soup Granda from the Ozark Mountain Daredevils decided to come out here and play with you guys tonight. So let's bring them on, shall we? I love this guy so much. I do. And I love this band so much. If there was ever a band in the history of KY102 and Cowtown Ballroom and all of that shit, it has to be the Ozark Mountain Daredevils. I think we got about 9 or 10 of them on stage. So Kansas City, how about a nice KY102 Kansas City welcome for international recording artists, the Ozark Mountain Daredevils.
Two.
Good morning.
I've been standing on the rock, waiting for the wind to blow. I've been standing on the rock, waiting for the wind to blow. I've been standing on the rock, waiting for my seeds to grow. I've been walking on the ground, waiting for the guns to quit. I've been walking on the ground, waiting for the guns to quit. I've been walking on the ground, waiting for the pieces to fit.
Play the harp, boy.
Boy. Better get back to the country. Look around and find you a home. Better get back to that country. That's where we all come from. I've been standing on the rock, waiting for the wind to blow. I've been standing on the rock, waiting for the wind to blow. I've been standing on the rock, waiting for my seeds to grow.
Almost legal.
I'm standing on a rock, waiting for the seeds to grow.
Only took 50 years.
I'm standing on a rock, waiting for the seeds to grow.
Turn the harmonica down, brother.
I'm fading back.
I know.
Either turn him up or turn me down. Okay, I'm going to start it. Chicken train running all day. Chicken train running all day. Chicken train running all day. Can't get on, can't get off. Chicken train taking the chickens away. Laser beam in my dream. Laser beam in my dream. Can't get on, can't get off. Laser beam like a sawed off dream. Ha ha ha!
chicken train running all day. Chicken train running all day. Chicken train running all day. Can't get on, can't get off. Chicken train, take your chickens away.
Instrument is called the mouth bow. Very few players play that.
Any questions? All right. All right, how's that right here? We all right? All right, good deal. Back in the late 1700s. It's on our very first record. The first song we've ever done.
Did.
First song we ever did. The first song we have ever done.
Correct grammar.
This is for our country girl, Becky.
Won't you come to me tonight, oh country girl?
bother me with delight, oh country girl. All you drive away to pay, oh country girl. You make sunshine of the day. Well, you make sunshine.
All right. Right. Song called Follow the Southern Cross. Never hurt nobody, did it? Well, maybe a couple guys.
don't know. Randy Rayleigh, you seem to be looking good through it all, my friend. Okay, this is one of the very first songs we ever did in December of 1971 when we first got together. It's called Noah Had to Ride the Storm Before He Got the Sign. So this is our acid rock number of the evening. So is there anybody here tonight on acid? Okay. I'd just like to say, All right. Stopped raining. It's kind of a nice evening, isn't it? Yeah, I am. I'm ready to sing a song. Oh, there's that fiddle. Song for all the wine lovers here this evening called Homemade Wine, Maestro. Down in the hills of the Ozarks, there are some women that I have. Tequila, tequila, tequila. Thank you, thank you, thank you. You got it, girl. All right.
I found this on my amp, so I think I'm supposed to do something.
All right, we'll do a song. You may not know this, but we have a new record out. We've been together 47 years. And we put a new record out. You remember records, right?
New baby.
But we have a CD out. Now, I don't really have a problem with CDs, but, well, yeah, I do. I got two problems. One is I can't read them because they're so little. And the second problem I have is, did you ever try to roll a joint on a CD cover?
What's the spelling?
I don't know. But anyway, we have a new CD out. We put it out here just a few months ago. We're still alive and kicking. But I think you can get it over there at the little stand over there with shirts and hats. And the swimsuit calendar is out again this year. So that's a real, hey, Joe, huh, man? All right. But anyway, we're going to do a song or two from the new records. First song is, I think, the first song on the record, isn't it? Yeah. Oh, it's one of them, believe me. Okay. It's one of them, okay? Believe me. Thank you.
said that you loved me, I thought you cared, but you just wanted to change me. When you said my hair's too long, I saw those scissors, baby.
Good and funky. All right, thank you very much. Okay, now we're going to go back and do a real old one, and then another new one, and then another old one, and then one that's kind of new, but not so new, but then another old one, and then a new one, then an old one. Okay, this is a song that we made on a record of ours called It'll Shine When It Shines. We made right here in the great state of Missouri. We never moved to Los Angeles. We stayed here in Missouri. And we're happy for it. But this was a song that did very well for us off our It'll Shine When It Shines record.
She's wearing a crown.
welcome.
All right, thank you very much. All right. Okay, we got two songs. One about going down to the lake, one about going down to the river. What do you want to hear? Go down to the river? All right. Hit it, boys. I'm going down to the river. I'm gonna take my new canoe. I'm gonna rock and roll it over. Baby, you can do it too. Baby, you can do it too. I'm going down to the river. I'm gonna take my fishing pole. I'm going hook, line, and sinker. I'm looking for a fishing hole. Looking for the fishing hole. Down at the river, you never say never. Your wishes are the fishes floating by forever. Get out of the water, climb up on the ridge. Before you know it, you'll be jumping off the bridge. I'm going down to the river. I'm gonna take my swimming suit. I'm gonna float out in the water. Cause I don't really give a hoot. Another new song on a new record, new CD. It's called Off the Beaten Path, and it's over there. Did I ever tell you about the souvenir stand? Okay, well then I won't tell you again. But there's only 131 shopping days till Christmas. I don't want to bum anybody out or anything, but nothing says I love you like our stupid shit.
It's a new song off the new record.
Yeah. a kid, everything we did happened in the neighborhood. Birds would tweet, air smells sweet, everything was pretty good.
All that changed, the world got strange, it got really weird.
Mama got a tan, daddy liked that, I just grew up here.
And the poison rain keeps running down the drain. Ain't no way to win this game that we're in. There's no way out.
Trouble on the left, trouble on the right, trouble in the middle too. Endless war, revolving door, what are we supposed to do?
Album by CD or download at theozarkmountaindaredevils.com.
All right, here's another old one for you. Far it'll shine when it shines record. Everybody here?
Yep.
I've got a mountain of dreams to climb before I get to that house on the hill. Lady of my morning in a brown earthen pot on the sill of the window that looks out across the valley, probably always will. have put an end to this grief by giving myself the pot plant and a rainbow, calling it a reef. She's the energy that runs my day and the first star out at night. It takes every bit of my might. In the morning, the early summer breezes call, lead me away from my warm, sleepy bed and fill me up with expectations of filling this hole in my head that left long ago. In my lifetime and left me feeling dead. She's the energy that runs my day and the first star out at night. My morning in a brown earthen pot on the sill of the window that looks out across the valley, probably always will.
Thank you very much.
Hopefully we can get a train to go by on this song.
Choo-choo! Choo-choo!
you.
Lord, I made it to the station with my suitcase in my hand.
We'll do another song off the new record. Then we'll bring it down to home stretch. How's that sound? All right? Hold on, we're going to switch around a little bit for this song. All right, everybody here? All right. One more time, I'm going to remind you about our new record. It's the first record we've had out in 14 years or so. But when you've been together 48 years, you know, a new record is a good thing. Hey, we just want a song. It's called A Waltzin' with Lady St. Louis.
Sitting on the banks of the river, watching river boats go by, wearing her arch in a halo, made from the stars in the sky. I love my Lady St. Louis, and the sparkle in her eyes. I love it when she sings Louie Louie. If all anxiety, now I'm waltzing with Lady St. Louis. So happy, carefree and gay. I'm waltzing with Lady St. Louis, dancing the night away. Her mother came down from Chicago, dressed in gingham green. Her daddy was a river. I sit by the side of the water in the land of the midnight sun. Show me the way to the west, cause I'm one of St. Louis' sons. Now I'm waltzing with Lady St. Louis. So happy, kiss.
waltzing with Lady St. Louis, dancing the night away.
All right. They don't write waltzes anymore, do they? All right. A good waltz is good for the soul. All right. Let's go down the road, boys and girls. In a brand new car. Hit me, Rongo. Big cigar and play to win. Drive around like a star, not a has been. And if that don't make it, that's taking shape. It ain't my dust. My combinations loop like a bucket of rust.
There you are, Danny.
Yeah. For listening to us. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, how fitting is this to have the celebration of KY102 with guys from Springfield, Missouri, huh? When the Daredevils are done, the party goes right next door, so don't even think about leaving, okay?
We'll be right over.
The Daredevils are done. Way Too Famous is going to take that stage right there. We have shirts for sale. We have hats for sale. We have stickers for sale. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't know of a better man in my life, a nicer guy, a better friend in my life than Michael Soup Granda, ladies and gentlemen.
All right. Thank you. Randy Rayleigh, folks. KY102.
And I just want to say I'm so proud and humbled to have Michael and the rest of the band here. This is what it was like in 1974, guys, okay?
The Cowtown Ballroom.
Cowtown Ballroom. Ladies and gentlemen, how about a nice round of applause for the Ozark Mountain Daredevils?
Thank you very much. Let's rock and roll. All right. We'll do one more right here. But we'd like for you to sing along with us.
Hey, Rick. One of our old roadies from back in the day, Rick Redford right here.
Kansas City, Missouri. Rick Redford, come sing with us.
Lovely, wonderful Abigail Waterworth. Going to help us sing. You guys are going to help us sing. I want to dedicate this song to an old friend of ours on the road with us for many years from Kansas City, the greatest light man that ever lived, Danny Mayo. This song is for you. He loved this song. Please help us sing along. It's called It'll Shine When It Shines.
The old cat on the roof, he can stand a little push, 'cause he's got 9 good lives to live. But like my mom said, you only live till you're dead. You got to give and give and give. There's a pebble in the pond, ripples and rains. There's a leaf in the wind that don't know where to end, chasing days and wings and wishes and dreams. Seems like everyone is out looking for the sun, singing rain and rain on me. One good song to sing. And like my daddy said, it's in your heart, not your head. You got to sing, sing, sing. There's a window in the wall, looking out on it all, leaving fears and tears and troubles alone. There's a fire in the stove, keeping out the cold. Warm and wine and winter, babies and home.
Thank y'all very much. Thanks for listening to us.
We love Knucklehead.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Ozark Mountain Daredevil.
Thank you.